CBSE class 12 physics NCERT solutions in the chapter ray optics and optical instruments. This is exercise 9.5. We see how to solve this one. First I will read this question. A small bulb is placed at the bottom of a tank containing water to a depth of 80 centimeter. Tank containing water. Okay, it contains water. 80 centimeter, let's say 0.8 meter. What is the area of the surface of water through which light from the bulb, let's say here is the bulb. Okay, area of the surface of water area through which light from the bulb can emerge out. Okay, you are asked to consider the bulb to be a point source. Okay, let's see. Suppose if you consider a point here, the light will come, will go out. Similarly, this side also, you can assume both the sides are very symmetric. Assume the tank is extending to this side as good as this side also, right? So let's consider any one side, find R, then the full circle will be pi R squared. Now you can see any ray here, it will undergo refraction. It goes from denser to rarer, deviates away from the normal. You consider a ray here. This ray doesn't go to the outer surface, outer area of the tank. It doesn't go out the tank, go out of the tank. Right? What will happen here? It will graze the surface. Any angle more than that, it will undergo total internal reflection. There is no possibility of this light going out and reach the observer. So what is the maximum angle up to which the ray can undergo refraction and go to outer world? This one. That should be the critical angle. So take this angle to be the critical angle. We represent C as the critical angle here, and these two are normals. If the ray is incident at here, where the angle is greater than the critical angle, it will undergo total internal reflection. So under the limiting case, we will have to consider only the angle up to the critical angle, angle of incidence on the water air interface up to the critical angle. Okay? Yeah. Now you can see here, we know that mu is equal to 1 by sin c. C is the critical angle. We are using that symbol. Mu is 1 by sin c, where mu is the refractive index of the denser medium. Here the denser medium is water. Compared to air, this is denser medium. So it should be 1 by sin c. Mu is equal to. But mu is given to be 1.33. Just for convenience sake, you take it as 4 by 3. Therefore, mu is 4 by 3 is 1 by sin c, which gives you sin c as 3 by 4. You can check your steps. By any chance, if you wrote 4 by 3 as sin c, then sin c will be 4 by 3. That would be wrong, because the value of any sine angle cannot be greater than 1. So now this is right. Sin c, we are after all getting 3 by 4. It is possible. Okay. Also, this sin c is R by S, sin c, R by S. So this is sin c R by, because S is square root of H squared plus R squared. Okay, this is C, mean this is also C, alternate angle. Therefore sin c is R by S. S is root of R squared plus H squared. Sin c, R by S, S is root of h squared plus r squared. Our aim is to find pi r squared. So first square these two terms, you will get 9 by 16 is equal to r squared by h squared plus r squared. Therefore, 9 h squared plus 9 r squared is 16 r squared. Cross multiply. Therefore, 16 r squared minus 9 r squared is 9 h squared. So, 7 r squared is 9 h squared, which gives you r squared as 9 by 7 h squared. Here itself you will know that r is greater than h because this is 9 by 7. These are all little points. R is greater than h means when you draw the diagram, you should draw this to be greater than this. If you want perfection, r squared is 9 by 7 h squared. So you get this r greater than h. This is h from here to here. Here to here h. So draw r more than h in the diagram. Of course, it's not a big thing, but still I am saying if you want any perfection in the diagram, you draw r to be greater than h. Okay, when you draw it, because you see here r is greater than h. R is 9 by 7 times root 9 by 7 times h, or r squared is 9 by 7 times h squared. Okay, yeah, we want pi r squared. So area A is pi r squared pi into 9 by 7 h squared. 2.59 meter square. So 2.6 meter square. So area of the circle through which light can emerge out from water and reach the observer outside, 2.6 meter square.